So good evening to everybody. So we shall continue our structures now. I think you are having columns and struts, and you already considered that Euler's formula. That Euler's formula valid for which type of columns? Euler's formula valid for long columns only. Now, then you are having one more formula, what is called as Rankine's formula. Rankine's formula. Good. Look at this formula now. So one more you are having, what is called as Rankine's formula. Look at the concept. I think you have studied all these things. You have already studied now. What the importance of this Rankine's formula? Yes, consider both the loads. Which are those loads? So in the case of Euler's formula, you call it as a buckling load. It buckles, fails by buckling. In case of short column, fails by crushing. Yes, consider crushing load. Therefore, introduce what is called as the Rankine's formula, 1 divided by P suffix R equal to 1 divided by P buckling, buckle load, plus of 1 divided by P crushing load. This is the way in which you have taken the crushing load and the buckling load into consideration. Black pen, huh? Right. Look at here. So here PR represent, PR represent Rankine's load. Rankine's load. P suffix buckle, that's buckling load. Buckling load. Then P suffix crush, crushing load. Crushing. That's all. Yes, consider both the things into consideration here. Now, I consider about your crushing load pre-crush. That is crushing load will be equal to. How you have calculated your strength of the concrete by using your compressive strength testing machine. Compressive strength, 150 mm cube you had conducted. You have calculated the crushing strength or a characteristic strength of concrete at 28 days. How you have calculated that crushing strength or a fracture strength? How that strength you have calculated, maybe M15. You got the value maybe 16 MPa or 16 Newton. How that stress you arrived? Load divided by area. Then what is load is equal to? I want the load now. Stress into area. You catch my point now. It is nothing but stress into area. It is nothing but here sigma c, crushing stress into area of the section. That's all. So I can have the crushing load will be equal to crushing stress into area of the member. Stay. Sigma C is the crushing stress. Crushing strength or the crushing stress. Crushing strength or ultimate strength. That will be equal to load divided by crushing load divided by area. Load by area. The stress will be equal to. So now I computed the value of the crushing load. Same way. You know the formula for P buckling. You know that. What would be the formula for buckling load? You have computed. You have to remember the formula. What the formula? Pi squared EI divided by L squared. Correct? Huh? Formula correct? Huh? Pi squared EI by L squared. Check up the formula. Is it correct? Already having that Rankine's formula, buckling load. That is the effective length, minimum pi squared EI by L squared. Sari Daniya? Formula kutilva? Adagilva ilva? ಕಾಲಮ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಅದಾಗಿಲ್ವಾ? ಸೊ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಆಯ್ತಾ? ಹಾ, ನೌ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ನೌ, ಓಕೆ, ಇಫ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಕೇಸ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ದಟ್ ಪಿ ಬಕಲ್ ಬಕ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಲೋಡ್, ಸಾರಿ ಬಕ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಲೋಡ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಕ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಲೋಡ್ ಆರ್ ಪಿ ಬಕ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಬಕ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಲೋಡ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಆರ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಯೂಲರ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ. Euler's formula. That formula we called as Euler's formula, that would be equal to pi squared EI by L squared. So pi squared EI by L squared. But the effective length laithalva, the effective length gulu, different conditions, everything is over. Then you take that Euler's formula, that is equal to pi squared EI by L squared and the formula step. Now one by one you tell me. E and Reno. Young's modulus. E Young's modulus. Okay. I and the moment of inertia. So this moment of inertia will be I minimum generally. It should be minimum moment of inertia. You have to take into consideration. I moment of inertia. L and the no. L. L is the effective length. L is the effective length. L is the effective length. We know already L is equal to effective length. Sometimes they use the symbol L suffix E. Confuse markabadi. L O or L suffix E. Whatever you have taken, you take that value as LE, effective length. So this is Euler's formula, valid for. So you take one note here, Euler's formula valid for. Long columns, like I said, buckling loads only. Euler's formula valid for, note, Euler's formula valid for long columns. Euler's formula valid for long columns. Valid for long columns. Valid for long columns. Bracket only buckling loads. Buckling loads. Well, that is a limitation for this. Now here we know the buckling load. At the same time you must know about the slenderness ratio. I already given the formula for slenderness ratio. What is slenderness ratio? Lambda L by R, R minimum, whatever it means, you take it, L by, generally L by R minimum or R. Can you simplify this formula in terms of that lambda here? Look at, I have simplified such a way. This lambda L divided by R minimum, or L is equal to effective length is equal to lambda into R, or R minimum. No doubt L is equal to lambda into R. And moment of inertia I is equal to, with respect to the radius of gyration and the area, how to define the term moment of inertia? Formula for the moment of inertia with respect to radius of gyration. Int will be given to you. If I know the area, if I know the radius of gyration, is it possible to calculate the moment of inertia? I know area, I know the radius of gyration. How to calculate the moment of inertia? I, moment of inertia. So R is equal to, okay, R is equal to root of I by A. Correct? We already know that. Nothing but I is equal to AR squared. In tundre, AR squared. Look at how this formula, basic if you know it, you can have in the different way. ಯಂಗ್ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರು ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಮಾಡುವಂತ ಒಂದು ತಾಕತ್ ನಿಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ಬೇಕು. ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಟ್ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟ್. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ದ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ಬಟ್ ಫಂಡಮೆಂಟಲ್ ನೆವರ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್. ನೌ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಐ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ವಿತ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ಯರ್ ಪೈ ಸ್ಕ್ವರ್ಡ್, ಐ ಕಾಂಟ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಇಟ್, ಈ ಯಂಗ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಯುಲಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್. ಹೈ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಇಂಟು ಆರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವರ್ಡ್. Correct? Huh? Now, can I take L squared? So L is equal to lambda into R, correct? Huh? Can I take L squared as lambda squared into R squared, correct? Huh? Lambda squared into R squared? R squared. That is R minimum or R squared. Because this is also R minimum, I am not convinced. What happens to your formula? Pi squared EA by lambda squared. Look at here. So one time in the examination, that's the thing. That's a trick in the examination. Stay near illa. Now we are going to do buckling load, P buckling, something, buckling load equal to pi squared by EI by L squared, pi squared EI by L squared. Example bannide. Adhe question bannide, Rankine's formula. But he has not given the formula this way. This formula is not given, but he has given the formula pi squared EA by lambda squared. And different formulas are given. Not the same formula again. Again, red answer contractor. The answer he has given in terms of this way. Pi squared EA by lambda squared. If you remember at least one formula, it is fundamental, other than changes illa. Fundamental formula, then if they are given in terms of standards ratio and the area of the member, it can be reduced to this one. So this is the way the questions are altered. Adhan helad. Buckling load kottidane. Rankine's formula ne kottidane. He has given that Euler's formula ne kottidane. But instead of given direct approach, indirect way has given the formula this type also. Anything. I'm not worried about that. But in any way, if you're asking, ಫಂಡಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಏನ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ ನಾನೇನ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಬೈ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಟ್ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಒಂದು ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಜ್ಞಾಪ ಇಟ್ಕೋಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಈ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ನೋ ದಿ ಟರ್ಮಿನಾಲಜಿ ಅಂತ ಅಷ್ಟೇನೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ಐ ಅಂದ್ರೇನು ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನರ್ಷಿಯಾ ಅಗ್ರಿ ಹೌ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ದ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನರ್ಷಿಯಾ ದಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ ಸೊ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನರ್ಷಿಯಾ ಐ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಫಂಡಮೆಂಟಲ್ ದೆನ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಬೈ ಚಾನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಎಲ್ ಬೈ ಆರ್ ಇಫ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ದ ಲೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ I can take lambda into R, length of the member. Aste, nen extra adugudilla. This is the way the problems are. You got the idea? Now, after knowing all these things, now we are simplified. You not asked the derivation. Then derivation kodala. Now you have taken directly the value of this Rankine's load. PR is equal to. So direct formula here that you remember after simplification. The formula works out to area into sigma c divided by 1 plus sigma c by pi squared e into lambda squared. That's all the formula. So this is the formula. They derived it such a way. 1 plus sigma c pi squared e into lambda squared. So to arrive the formula for Rankine's formula, that Rankine load will be given by Rankine load will be, this is the formula. What is A? Area. Sigma C, crushing stress. You can easily calculate. Then already know E, Young's modulus, lambda, standards ratio. So sometimes in the same Rankine's formula, you may specify Rankine's constant. He introduced one more, what is called as Rankine's constant. Rankine's constant. They sometimes use the symbol alpha, Rankine's constant. So that Rankine's constant, he has taken this sigma c divided by pi squared e is the Rankine's constant. Sigma c divided by pi squared e is called as Rankine's constant. These are the possibilities in the case of your that sigma c by pi squared is called as Rankine's constant. So if that is the case, your formula will be reduced as to PR is equal to A into sigma c divided by 1 plus alpha into lambda square. This can also be given this way. So they are simplified. That PR is equal to A into sigma C in divided by 1 plus alpha lambda squared. These are the things here. Now, The questions may be of this type. Rankine's formula valid for given buckling load, given crushing load, given both crushing load and buckling load. They're given none of the above. Correct answer. Both for buckling and crushing. That's all. That's all the thing you have to take. Instead, idralle at question neeve prepare maarabodu. In different way, if you're asking the question, you are ready to answer it. So this formula is valid for both buckling load and crushing load. That is for any columns. Maybe a short column, maybe a long column, maybe a intermediate column also. Note down one by one. Note. Number one. Rankine's formula is valid for any type of call. That is, we know already, short column, long column, intermediate, whatever, any type of column. Second one. It is valid for crushing load and buckling load. It is valid for crushing load and buckling load.